Good morning, friends. My name is Chetan Jadhav. I welcome you to my channel. Today we will talk about the surging and choking phenomena in the centrifugal compressor. So I have drawn one graph, which is head versus discharge graph. Okay. So in this, we can see here, this is the point A, right? Now, at this point, the discharge is zero. Okay. So what will happen here? The pressure is increased. This pressure from zero to A. Okay. This pressure is due to the impeller. Okay. When the impeller is rotating, it imparted some pressure to the fluid. Okay. So this pressure zero to A is, that is due to the pressure imparted by the impeller. Now we can see, as the discharge increases from this point to this point, okay, the head is also increases. So that is due to the diffusion action in the diffuser. Okay, so what is the function of diffuser? So it will convert the kinetic energy given by the impeller, and it will convert into the pressure energy into the diffuser section, right? So from A to B, so this is the positive slope and it is generally unstable operation. Okay, so during A to B, the pressure is gradually increases with respect to discharge. As the discharge increases, pressure is also increases from A to B point. Okay, and beyond point B, we can see as the discharge increases, but the pressure is decreases. So this is the negative slope and this is the stable operation point. Okay, now why the pressure is decreases even after the discharge increases? So that is due to the frictional and the another losses by the flow separation. Okay, so this is due to the increase in the losses. So discharge increases but pressure is decreases after the point B. Clear? At the point B, we are getting the maximum efficiency. Okay, because we are getting the maximum head. At this point, we will get the minimum, or can say zero efficiency, because we are not getting any kind of head. There isn't any kind of pressure rise in this. Okay. Okay. Now we'll talk about the surging process. Now what is happen actually in the surging process? Look. So we'll see in this region during A to B. So this is the positive slope region. Okay. And in that region, at particular point D. Okay. Now what happened? Due to increase in the friction or increase in the load, suppose the discharge is gradually, or the it is decreases. So discharge decreases from D to D dash, from here to here. So discharge decreases. Now though this point is on the positive slope side, its head is also decreases. Okay. Now what will happen? Suppose the discharge valve is closed and we are decreasing the discharge. So what will happen at the centrifugal pump side? At the compressor side, there will be a sudden pressure drop is there. Okay, at this region, at the end of the compressor, there will be a sudden pressure drop. But at the downstream side, the pressure drop is not sudden. Okay, so momentarily what will happen? The downstream side pressure will be higher than the compressor side. Okay, so there is a pressure gradient and the pressure will flow from higher pressure to the lower pressure side. Okay, so there is a reversal of flow is there from the downstream side, or we can say receiver side, to the compressor side, because we can see here as the discharge decreases, pressure head is also decreases, right? So the pressure will, or we can say air will flow from downstream side to the compressor side. Now what will happen? Discharge is low and we are getting the another discharge from the reverse direction. So again discharge will decreases, again discharge will decreases, and the pressure head also decreases. So it will decrease up to this point. Beyond that, the pressure will not decrease, because the compressor, or we can say impeller, is imparted some energy. Okay, so pressure will not drop beyond this point A. Okay, now the reverse flow is possible only up to this point A. Now what will happen? As I told you, in the downstream side, pressure is not drop rapidly, but it drops gradually. And when the pressure at the downstream side is lower than the pressure A, at that time what will happen? The flow will again go in the forward direction. Because now what is the actual scenario? The compressor side pressure is higher and the downstream side pressure is lower. Now the flow will go in the reverse direction. Okay, so this to and fro motion of the air, this phenomena is generally known as the surging process, and the problem due to that is it will create the vibrations and it may damage the rotating parts of the compressor. So this phenomena is generally avoided in the compressors. Okay, for that the surge control valve is also there, which I am not mentioned in this case. Okay, now we'll talk about the B2C point. So why the surging is not occur during this region? So reason behind that is what? As the discharge decreases from here to here, okay, as the discharge decreases, but pressure is not decreases, head is increases. So there will be a never reverse flow in this region. Okay, so during B2C, even after decrease in discharge, the head is increases. Okay, so there will be a never reverse flow in this region. So the surge is only occur during the positive slope side, and that's why it is known as the unstable operation. Okay, now we will talk about the other phenomena, that is the choking. Choking, that means what? So as the mass flow rate increases, the density will decreases. Okay, so mass flow rate increase and density decrease. So ultimately what will happen? The velocity of flow will increases. And if the velocity of flow will achieve the sonic velocity, okay, so at that point, this point is mentioned here, it is E. At the E point, the velocity is sonic velocity. And beyond point E, what will happen? The discharge will not increase further. Okay, even after fully close of the discharge valve, okay, discharge will not increase. So that is known as the choking point in case of compressor. Right, so always the compressors are designed between B to E point. So beyond that, there is a surging phenomena will occur, and after E point, the choking phenomena will occur. Right, so the compressors are always designed between B to E point. This is known as the working range of the compressor. I hope you guys understand all these things. Thank you so much.